half of us have to sleep in the living room.
Probably more than half of us.
Yeah.
Ooh. Okay.
Yeah, I'm up at Brooklyn, now I'm down in Tribeca, right next to the narrow, but I'll be hood forever. I'm the new Sinatra, and since I made it here, I can make it anywhere.
Yep, we made it here, folks.
We can make it anywhere.
It's just a plane ride to make it anywhere.
Bing bong.
Welcome to Low Effort High Reward, a New York edition. We have
what is this called?
Low Effort High Reward.
Low Effort High Reward. I like that.
We have, of course, Alex is here.
Yeah. Hello, folks. We've got John Luna.
Right. And then
I'm Nick Torchon.
Right. Nick Torchon. Guest.
Whoa, you're more Asian than I remember, Nick.
and you live with
it
him.
Happens to Jews as they get older.
Well, they turn Chinese.
They turn Chinese. That's why they have Christmas at Chinese restaurants.
Oh, that's good. That's good. That's tell the people who you are.
I'm Tian Chen. No relation.
I just played some claps. Yeah. Okay, so we just flew in from L.A.
Yep.
Los Angeles.
And boy, are my arms tired. Come on.
Yeah. All those bags too. I was having to switch arms the whole time.
They've been saying that nonstop for 4 hours.
Yeah, you think it's gonna stop?
You think it started here?
No, I love every second.
All right, so
I'm loving every second.
So we are we're here and we just wanna what do we wanna denounce talk about?
Denounce. Let's denounce some people. No,
where to start, dude? There's so many people to denounce.
Yeah. We just got in, and we're a little delusional. And
we're always a little delusional.
We're comics.
No, we took a red eye that left at 11:30, got into New York at about 7:30, and then had to wander the streets for 8 hours before we were allowed to get into this Airbnb.
Well, let's start at the beginning.
I show up.
So listen, I text Alex, I go, Alex and Nick are already at the airport. I text him, I go, you guys at the airport yet? They go, yeah, we're at the bar. So then I get to the bar, I go, can we order some drinks? And they go, oh no, last call was 30 minutes ago. I was like, oh, thanks for telling me.
Yeah, I mean, last call at the airport bar is 10 o'clock, which is out of control. I don't know why.
So then then I got some chicken tenders, and then I got on the flight.
Sick.
So I got on the flight last because I was waiting for the chicken tenders. I'm sitting in comfort.
Imagine if you missed your flight for airport chicken tenders.
No, they were like last call for the flight to New York City.
You really wanted these fucking tenders.
By the time he got on the plane, they had closed all the overhead
compartments. They had.
The pilot I just imagine him standing there with a fucking bucket of stale chicken tenders.
She was doing the like the seatbelt thing, and I was like, "Hey, can you move, please?" Eating chicken tenders as I was walking. And also I didn't want to eat chicken tenders on the plane, so like when the walk from the ticket thing to onto the plane
in the hallway,
yeah, I was like just scarfing the chicken tenders down. And so I get to my seat. The guy obviously was thrilled that I was sitting next to him, as most people are on planes,
because John picked a window seat, which is a bold move.
I always pick a window seat.
What are you, five? You need to look out the window. Ooh, clouds. As we take off.
No grown man should ever pick a window seat. Dude.
Honestly, it was the last seat, but in a given a choice, I would pick a window.
He's a kid at heart, yep. Folks.
And so I walk in. Alex is already on the plane. Alex, for some reason, wants to be the first person on the flight. Like as we were,
he
like
strikes me as that kind of person.
Yeah, as we were boarding, he's like, I think I'm sky priority. I think I should go now.
And I was.
And I was like, no, you weren't. You just told me you weren't.
No, I wasn't the priority for the security check-in.
Okay, no, I'm sorry for yelling at you.
We were both sky priority. They go comfort plus. Oh, he's comfort plus. You get in the left lane.
Did they?
Yeah. Oh. I cut so many poor people.
I actually do love doing that when I'm in first class because the seat is nice. Mm-hmm. If it's a comfort plus seat, I don't want to sit in it. You can pick up your phone.
No, just ignore that. We got to be professional here.
Okay.
We'll fix that in post.
So John gets on and he's walking down the aisle. And
so this podcast is just us talking about our day?
What else is there to do on a podcast?
We were just recounting how we got here.
No.
Then we're going to do one at Gallagher's on Sunday night in the restaurant.
Oh, boy.
And what do you think all of the most successful podcasts are? It's just people that have fame talking about their day.
That's true.
Yeah.
We're lacking one important component of that.
This is my podcast. Yeah. You're just a guest.
I know. I kind of like the idea that my mic is not even plugged in.
It's not.
Here, it's muted.
You don't even get the muting jokes. Okay, so here's the thing.
The guy was not thrilled to see John.
Yeah, obviously.
Wait, I thought you guys sat next to each other.
Hey, stop skipping ahead, man.
Oh, shit, fuck.
This is a 45-minute spoilers
alert.
So Alex, actually, we didn't buy our tickets together. We just both happened to pick row 16. I bought my ticket last, and I think Alex was the first person on that flight to buy a ticket, so it was crazy that we picked the same row. Mm-hmm. And so I walk in. I see a man with a full hospital face mask on, and I'm like, pfft. And then I realize it's Alex.
Well, okay, because I sat down on the flight, and my original seat, I was sitting next to this young lady, and she was wearing a full N95, and I was like, oh, she's going to hate me if I don't put a mask on, because she clearly hates everyone in here that doesn't have a mask on. And I'm not trying to make enemies on a 6-hour red eye.
Right. Yeah. 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 So
yeah, my flight was so much cooler. Nobody was wearing masks. Everybody on that
Alex
flight
was
got
the only
COVID
person
already.
Wearing a mask.
No, Nick was wearing a mask too. And the girl that I was sitting next to, the three of us were the only ones wearing masks.
So so I see Alex, and it's one of those planes where it's two seats, three seats, two seats.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm in like the window seat on the two seat, and Alex is on the aisle on the other side.
Yeah.
So I'm like, Alex, you wanna sit next to me? And he's like pretending not to know me.
No. Here's the thing. John wants me to make the girl sitting next to me switch with him.
No, that's not true. I was asking if you wanted me to ask the guy next to me.
Yeah, just ask him.
But I wanted to make sure it was okay with you before I made that. Okay, I didn't know. I'm very insecure. I thought maybe Alex didn't want to sit next to me. That's how crazy I am.
I wasn't like thrilled about it.
Yes, you were. Shut up.
He was like trying to avoid eye contact.
Dude, it was better for you. Okay, I didn't want to bring this up yet, but it was good that you switched too.
John?
You fucking move so much at night.
Yeah, because, okay, yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
But the person I was sitting next to before was tiny, and they were going to be hunched in the corner the whole time, so I would have had a seat and a half.
Dude, there was one point where you got up, and I thought you were going to go to the bathroom, so I like started to like kind of like spread out a little bit, and then you just made a circle and then sat back down like a fucking dog.
No,
dude.
I got up and I put a blanket down so it was a little more cushion.
That's what my dog does.
My bony ass was hurting on the seat. No, I didn't want to make a scene to go sit next to the guy who brought stale French fries on the plane.
Yeah, I did. So I came in with a bag of fries.
I was wearing the mask so I couldn't smell the French fries.
I came in with a bag of fries, sat down. So this is what happens. The guy's like, is this your seat? And I was like, yeah, sorry. And he's like,
sounds like you guys were just running first class.
Yeah,
fucking
business class.
We're the bad boys of business class. So I was like, let me sit down. And then he was like, okay. He's like, don't worry about it, man. I was like, I'm sorry. And then he gave, I was like, can you put my bag up? I was like, is there any more space?
John's making demands from a stranger that he's about to make leave.
I'm the last person on the flight. And he goes, yeah, give me your bag. And I like hand it to him, but I'm like, no, I want stuff. But I was like, he was already like grabbing it. So I'm like, can you bring it back down? So he brings it back down. Then
just
I'm like,
made this guy into your butler.
Then I'm like, I'm sorry, man. I take out my AirPods. I take out my my book I'm going to read. And then
John took his jacket off and made the guy fold it for
that's
him.
That's true.
The burning question on my mind is, did you actually read that book?
No.
100%. I brought a book too. I just looked at the cover.
They turned the lights off.
Oh. Oh, that's right. You guys were on a red eye.
Yeah. John pulls out a book and he goes, look, I got this book. And I'm like, oh, cool. How is it so far? He goes, well, I haven't actually opened it. And it's the most tattered book I've ever seen.
I said it more funny than that.
Which makes it even more insane that you wanted the window seat on a red eye. So you can look at
it
darkness.
It was the last seat. It was the last seat in Comfort Plus. Okay, so I sit down, and then that's at that point is when I'm like, all right, man. So I know that I've been lying to you that I was going to sit next to you this whole time. My friend is over there. Can we switch? And then he's the one that said, since I was already here, can you switch with the window seat on his side?
That's what he asked?
Yeah.
But this guy had the middle seat?
No, it was two.
Oh, it was aisle. Okay.
Instead of switching aisle for aisle, this guy wanted to switch window for window?
Yeah.
That's out of control.
No, so then that's why I said, like, oh, ask her. And then you were like, and then the flight attendant was walking by at the time. And then the flight attendant was like, is that your friend? And then he's like, yeah. And then he's like, okay, I'll switch. And then everyone was like, okay, cool. And then, cause he was like, does he have room up there? And I'm like, yeah, just switch the bags. Like, cause he's like, if I can put my bag up, I'll be fine. I don't care. And I was like, okay, cool.
So I bet if you didn't treat this guy like your personal concierge, you would have been more cooperative.
He was so nice. No. This guy, I cannot stress how
John
nice this guy.
John tipped him afterwards. Dude,
I cannot stress how nice this guy was. But then in the middle of the flight when he had the full baklava on.
So once they turned the lights on.
He had a Noah King-esque fucking baklava on.
They turned the
lights
on.
Baklava.
He had a Jewish dessert on.
It was covered in honey. It was weird.
Oh, fuck, dude. And cinnamon. This guy was wild.
No, it was like an Afghan
scarf. You guys should be proud of me. I even know what a
baklava.
Baklava is, Tom. We'll get it.
He legit, when they turned the lights off to go to sleep, he wrapped an Afghan scarf around his face. So he looked like a ninja. He only had like a slit for his eyes. And then he put a hood on over and he like went like this and slept like this the whole time.
That's bold.
He was kind of doing that Sam Bilski thing where the shirt is a little too small for him too.
Cut that out. Cool.
I can't call him fat. You guys do it to me all the time. What the fuck?
Yeah,
are you allowed to call someone skinnier than you fat?
Yes.
Okay, fair.
Are you allowed to call someone poorer than you poor?
Well, yeah, that's how it works.
Yeah, it'd be weird if you were calling somebody richer than you poor. Yeah, bro.
Are you allowed to call someone richer than you poor?
Depends.
Yeah, if you have schizophrenia, maybe.
I say no.
So this is why I'm mad at you that you're making fun of me for not reading. Because Alex sits down and the first thing he goes, you better not. Fuck, what did you say? You better not stop me from sleeping or something like that.
Oh, I said you better not try to talk to me. I want to try to sleep.
Oh, it was more curt than that. I remember it. I remember a little more curt.
I don't know. That's a name to me, not a adjective.
You don't know what curt means?
Let's move on. He played crickets.
Okay.
I'm going to just fill Tian in on all the soundboard stuff because it's like a very integral part of this. We need the crickets.
No, I appreciate that.
We were laughing loud.
Yeah, we were pretty obnoxious for the first hour of that
flight.
They
hated us. The people on the flight hated us.
I tried to sleep.
And it wasn't my fault. Alex is not a good... Alex couldn't sleep in Delta 1.
Yeah, no, see, the only way... I fall asleep right away if I'm laying on my stomach. But if I'm not on my stomach, whew, it's not going to happen.
Yeah, have you ever seen someone sleeping on their stomach in a first class?
Yeah, that would have been impressive if you could make that work.
Yeah. Yeah, I tried.
You're making full eye contact with a guy in the behind you.
And Alex's biggest problem when he flew Delta 1, he was like, my feet didn't have enough room. And this boy has fucking size 7 feet. And he's complaining that his feet doesn't have enough room.
I don't. John exaggerates things.
Okay, what size is your foot?
They're size 10.
How tall are you?
6'4". How was your flight, Tian?
It's very uneventful.
So,
John, you can't just like steamroll over a guest like that. It's really rude.
Oh, okay.
There was a lady who was... having difficulty like being alive. She had to keep having the flight attendants come to her and check on her health. I thought they were gonna land the plane because she was insanely old. She was like 100 last year, you know. She was
so
fucking old. Yeah,
she was heading to New York for her funeral. Yeah.
She had to make it for her funeral, but yeah, she just kept like wheezing and shit.
Probably because you're fucking vaping. She's
That's true. I was blowing vape smoke in her face.
She couldn't fucking...
Yeah, you're
invisible vape smoke right in her face.
Tian's now on an FBI do not fly list.
Wait, you know what we forgot about our flight? Can I interject this one thing?
Yeah,
remember it was
yeah.
so hot? at the beginning of the flight. No, it was like burning.
It was legitimately 80 degrees on the plane at the beginning. And they made an announcement.
It wasn't from my chicken tenders.
That's weird because usually like the flights are insanely cold at night.
Yeah.
No, they made an announcement. They were like, sorry, guys, it's hot.
Like, I was like, so can someone crack a window in here?
Yeah, you can't. There's no way you can fix that problem on a plane.
And then
yeah.
at one point they like turned the whole thing off, I think just to like reset it, and it worked. But for that like minute and like 2 minutes that it was turned off, oh my God.
Dude, if I had gotten on a plane and it was hot, I would get off, dude. Because something's not working right there.
Right?
If the AC is not working, like, it's not like cars where you can handle it. Everything has to be perfect on the plane.
Yeah, and our plane when we landed was, like, shaking, like, side to side, which I feel like isn't...
Oh, my God.
What, I brought up a thing that you brought up, and now I'm a fucking piece of shit because it was your point originally?
No, because we landed. No, let me explain it. Because we landed, and I go, don't you feel scared every time a plane lands? Because it's freaking shaking all over the place. And Alex is like, that's in your head, man. Like, I'm every time a plane lands, I'm probably the least scared I ever am. And then I'm like, it was shaking.
Yeah, it was shaking, but you said... Aren't you terrified every time a plane lands? No.
That's true. Yeah. When it lands, I'm like,
yeah, right? I'm like, oh, the hard part's
praying
done.
For a while.
And I have a question for you, Tian. Can planes drive by themselves?
Yeah, dude.
Or are they always getting... Wait, they can, because how do they take off? They don't get pulled.
But when they take off...
I love that you asked the question and answered it by yourself.
Well, because I figured it out. I was an idiot.
Yeah. Newsflash, everybody.
When I was flying to Austin, I was like, I went to the wrong terminal. Brag. And I had to take a bus. And I was like 5 minutes away from the plane departing. And I was stressed the fuck out. And the bus drives slow. It drives 20 miles an hour in the actual like... whatever it's called, the
tarmac.
The tarmac, and then we had to wait for this plane drive across the tarmac, and like watching a plane drive is fucking maddening, man. Because you know how fast they're capable of being, and you're watching it drive 40 miles an hour when you're like 2 minutes away from missing your flight.
It's like parallel parking. Yeah.
This bitch was driving so safe.
Did you miss that flight?
No, I didn't. I barely made it.
I've only missed two flights ever. One flight, I was in London with my mom. And
brag.
Yeah, I know. And we woke up and we thought the flight was like, basically we just thought the flight was later. And like we like woke up to like notifications. Well,
you didn't
on
care
my
to,
phone.
You didn't care to check?
Dude, on my phone, the app was like, boarding now. Like taking
You're
off.
Like, wait.
Like at the hotel.
Left. You missed it.
These tickets are in London time. Oh, shit.
So we literally waited for, so we just stayed an extra day. And then one time I was in Las Vegas and I had an Airbnb right next to the airport and I woke up maybe, 20 minutes before the flight was going to depart. And I like call an Uber immediately, throw my shit into my bag.
And you thought you were going to make it?
Dude, I'm like sprinting through the airport. I like bought Clear. I like did the free trial of Clear. So
yeah, that's optimistic that you even went.
So I could skip TSA. Dude, no, I was like 5 minutes from the airport. So I was like, if everything goes perfect, I can make it. I was like sprinting. I saw them close the door.
Wow.
You know what you got to do in those situations, and you gotta pretend like you're handicapped, and then they'll let you through. Just get yourself a wheelchair.
Yeah, just wear your handicap placard around your neck.
They actually gave me a better flight because I got to fly into Burbank when I lived in the Valley instead of LAX.
I missed back to back flights trying to come home from Indonesia or go from like Indonesia to Australia.
Brag.
Yeah. But hell yeah. Stop Asian hate, everyone. So the first one we missed because my sister was like taking too long putting on her makeup, and we're like driving there, and as we're driving there we get an email that they bumped our flight up.
Oh, that's dumb.
Dude, I hate when dude
that doesn't
do
make
that.
Any sense.
Yeah, and so we missed our flight and they like put us up in a hotel because it was like their fault. Yeah, it was also cool. Kind of mostly my sister's fault.
That's hella chill.
And they put us up in this hotel that had a mosquito infestation.
They always do.
Oh yeah. And I woke up, my mom's
in Indonesia.
In Indonesia, so like, of course. Like West, well, that's Nile the whole virus, country malaria. Really.
Yeah.
My mom has like pictures on like a fucking 2006 digital camera, mm-hmm. of just my whole arms swollen. Like every piece of my body that wasn't covered in clothes was just raised and itchy. Oh. And then we had this horrible nightmare of a thing. We get to the airport for our next flight and some dumb shit happens again. And they like, we missed a second flight and we had to wait like 8 hours for the next flight out at the same airport.
Dude, there's nothing worse than staying at a hotel near the airport.
In a third world country?
In a third world country.
There's nothing worse than a mosquito bite.
Yeah, try hundreds.
That is worse.
There's nothing worse than having to rush doing your makeup.
Yeah.
Where's the cricket sound?
You can feel free to hit that anytime John says something.
Now I know where it is.
They couldn't even hear you laugh. I muted you.
Yeah, but they knew.
They can see me laugh.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, I missed my my return flight from Austin because they had bumped my flight back. Like, what the fuck? Huh?
Nothing. Go ahead.
So I missed my flight because they had bumped my flight back 4 hours, and so I was like, all right, whatever. And I fell asleep at the airport, and I woke up 2 minutes after they departed.
No.
Yeah, dude.
How'd you find a place to lay on your stomach at the airport?
I was planking on one of the fucking seats. But, damn. I mean, silver lining the whole situation, they gave me first class on this flight, so.
Silver lining is playbook?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Great movie.
Play it.
Love Jennifer.
play the whole movie.
Play the whole movie.
All right, and we're back. That was a great film. Yeah, I love that movie.
Ups and downs in that one. Tian, do you know why you're supposed to put your seat in the upright position for landing and takeoff?
I think they just want to like make us feel their influence.
Yeah, no, I think it's purely like an authoritarian.
Yeah, it's like it's an safety. Ego thing.
Actually, yeah, maybe because in first class they don't make you do it.
Yeah.
They like kind of like just like turn a blind eye.
Yeah.
I've landed laying down before.
Never turned my phone off when they told me to turn my, and no plane I've been on has crashed.
I've never gone airplane mode.
I do, but
I go airplane mode in my fucking head, dude.
Yeah.
Dude, one time I was in the first class in the lay down and there was such bad turbulence and they like turned on the seatbelt sign and I'm like, if we're going down, I'd rather be laying down.
I'm going to die like comfortable.
Yeah, at that point.
And the laid out thing's like a little coffin, too. You got walls on each side.
Yeah, at that point, what's the... You're going to die. You're going to die. If you're crashing, what's
especially
putting
if
out
you're
the tray
going to do? If you're in first class. That's why they should put first class in the back of the plane.
I paid good money to die on this flight.
In loss, are any of them first class?
I see. So if they put first class in the back and you nosedive,
yeah, you should
then
survive.
You survive.
Yeah,
for maybe 2 seconds longer than everybody else.
Good. And I think that if the plane is going down and you jump at the right time, I think you can survive.
It's like, I always think that when I'm in an elevator, dude. Like if the elevator falls down the shaft, just jump at the right moment, you'll be good.
One time when I was in college, I was with like a big group of friends who were going to like a pledge meeting for our fraternity, and there were like 13 of us in an elevator, mm-hmm. and we're like, this is like the elevator in the library in our school. And we're like, it'd be so funny if we all jumped at the same time.
No.
And we were set to go to the third floor. We were going from the first floor to the passing the second floor,
uh-huh.
and we all jumped,
uh-huh.
and the elevator went and like dropped like a solid amount, and then it went up to the second floor, but the like number at the top read third floor, and it opened and let us out, and we were just like scattered into the library, and then that elevator was out of order for a week.
Jesus.
Yeah, it's Alex was in the fat fraternity, guys. That's
there were 13, 18-year-olds in a fucking elevator.
They were all 600 pounds.
Oh, yeah, describe them.
They look like John.
That's fucked up.
They all had psoriasis, is
cut,
what he means.
Cut that out.
Yeah, no, they're all Mexican. It was an agricultural school.
They're all gay.
Right,
there were a couple of gay people and Hispanic people, and my Rag. Fraternity, very diverse.
I've never met a Hispanic gay person before. Just a fun fact.
I'm trying to think of one.
What about
Mario Lopez? Is he gay?
What about the one guy that plays the gay guys in all of Adam Sandler's movies?
Rob Schneider?
No, not Rob Schneider. You know the one that...
Is Rob Schneider Mexican?
You know the longest yard? No, you know the longest yard?
Yeah.
You know the one that's like bad at football and like he has butterfingers, but he wants to be the quarterback and then he fucks...
Terry Crews?
Wait, he's gay? Butterfingers? Or does he have cum fingers, you know?
Well, it'd be better. He would be able to catch it.
You're right.
His cum is sticky.
No, it's pretty glossy.
I've never
It depends the difference.
I've never used cum as an adhesive before, but I feel like there's better.
Yeah. I've never cum. The room situation at this Airbnb.
Okay.
That's great.
What?
Well, there's 4 grown men and 3 beds.
No, there's not.
What do you mean, no, there's not?
There's three grown men.
Oh, wait.
Who's not the grown man?
He's counting himself. He's a they. He's not a man.
That's not funny. That's not a joke. That's then not a joking laughing? Matter.
Are you really?
Yeah. He's a he they.
Oh, sick.
That's
how you got the Joel spot.
No, because I'm bi. He didn't have any straight people or white people on that show.
Yeah, you should, fucking bullshit.
You should hit him up.
No, I'm hella straight.
Oh,
I'm the straightest.
Online, you're straight.
No, you're going for the fist bump is what you're doing.
Okay. I think he's straight
online. I was
trying
online. To do a mic tap, but like that's cool.
Bumping mics.
That was pretty gay, but like gay isn't happy.
All right, I'm going over my notes.
We're a bunch of gay lords.
Yeah.
Did I do the just flew in and boy are my arms tired?
Do it again. Do it again for the people in the back.
Okay. So we just flew in from LA and boy are my arms tired.
Yeah. I don't know how you managed with that suitcase.
Okay.
That's all your notes. Says that 8 times.
Last time we were in New York.
Oh God.
I'm excited to hang out with Alex because last time we were in New York, Alex was this is what it says in my notes. I don't know who wrote it. Alex was a Tinder hound. Literally the entire time he was swiping and messaging girls on Tinder. So I'm excited
to
have his I'm excited to have his full attention.
I don't want this in the I don't want
Well, you don't want your girlfriend to know that you fuck? She got to know that you know how to catch some fish, you know?
I'll say it more delicately.
The whole time we were in New York, I was swiping on Tinder because that's not true. I did a couple sets here and there.
Yeah, I was on stage some of the time.
Last time Alex was in New York, he was like a Pokemon trainer because he caught them all, dude.
All I mean, STDs. He honestly didn't. I mean, the Tinder didn't work out for him.
It did not.
Yeah. Oh. So, I mean, I'm just saying, but you were on it, though.
Yeah, but you were too. So it was literally, it was 3 guys staying together. What the fuck else were we going to do?
She's not going to watch this. So.
No, she will. She's very supportive.
Dude, if my girlfriend watched every second of this podcast, I would break up with her. I wouldn't respect her anymore. You need to make better use of your time, lady.
Adoria, if you made it this far.
Whoa, shout out Adoria, yeah. Perlor III. play one of her reels.
Play a clip of her saying, how much time do I have left?
How much time do I have? How much time do I have? Cool, how much time do I have?
So we have one room, and we have beds outside. So how are we going to divide this up?
The bright side is we have a big tub.
We definitely
so we can kill ourselves.
Yeah. They have 2 toasters.
2 toasters and a $5,000
You just need one
stove.
Toaster.
No, but you can't do that twice.
Oh,
it
fair.
Fries the toaster.
Okay, so 2 so at a time.
We got to kill ourselves in batches with toasters. But
we're not even on a high enough floor where it's a guaranteed death if we jump out.
Yeah, a lot of plants beneath.
Yeah, that's why I like the other Airbnb better.
Yeah, 47th floor, you don't stand a chance.
A sense of danger.
Yeah, that Airbnb kicks this Airbnb's ass.
Yeah,
fine.
But thankfully it was cheaper. So here's...
Also, the arrangement of the couches makes no sense.
Yeah.
And two people just
and
at least
and the nice thing about being in a worse Airbnb is you get an Airbnb host who has even less chill and is dude we got in so they she wrote like four separate three paragraph texts to me about like the rules of the place and in one of them she goes you guys can drop off your luggage at 11 but like you can't check in till like 2:30 at the earliest because like the cleaning people are in there. Yeah, so we go
they were.
We go to the doorman and we drop off our luggage at 10 because we were wandering around with our luggage for 3 hours.
Right.
Like we might as well just do it at 10. And she sends a text to me saying, I just got a phone call from the doorman. Apparently you left the luggage with him. I strictly said leave it at 11 in the room, which she didn't say. And she was very upset and was like, I'll let it slide this time, but just know like you're not allowed to do that.
Yeah,
why does that bother her even?
She gave us a cover story for if anybody asks what we're doing here, we have to lie to them and say we're visiting our friend Brian.
So it sounds like you guys have all the leverage.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, we're staying
you just
friends,
fucking throw that shit in her face.
Yeah.
Get her evicted.
That would be funny.
Yeah, that would be tight.
And then the place goes up for rent and we rent it.
Exactly.
Oh.
Hell yeah.
All happens within the span of 24 hours.
So the bed situation. I feel like we got to do a rotation.
Yeah, let's do rotation.
Now you're fucking making demands.
No, I'm having a lot of fun. So
I'm excited to be here.
Yeah, we couldn't do this anywhere but New York.
I mean, we wouldn't have that great story. So...
Yeah, we wouldn't have Nick and I wouldn't have gotten to wander Central Park for 4 hours today before this.
I sat in a little coffee shop. I'm not gonna blow up their spot though. but I sat in a little coffee shop, sat in a nice little big red chair. There's a weird part when this like security guard guy came in and he like looked and he looked at me like I was like he was gonna say something to me and I took out a headphone. And then he just like walked away. And then as he was walking away, he's like, the best chair's taken or something. It was very weird.
The security guard was mad that somebody was sitting in a chair at the coffee shop.
Yeah. But I don't think he was a coffee shop security guard. I think he was just a general.
For the city? like Batman?
Yeah. He's like, I'm comfortable chair security. You better be comfortable in that chair or you're arrested.
I was in it for so long. I was in it for like 4 hours, but I was working. I was working very hard.
Working harder.
I was working hard.
Okay.
For the weekend.
What do you do?
Your mom.
He literally watches a podcast. Yeah.
Somebody
and he calls
has
that
to.
Hard work.
That's not true.
That's what I do at work.
The watching the podcast part is the easy part. The editing, the ideation.
I don't even know what that word means.
Exactly. The producing. That's the hardest part.
Yeah.
And that's something only I could do. So in the group chat, what will I say when I'm coming home? should I say?
You should say, there's a full moon tonight, boys. The wolves are howling because his last name's Luna and that means moon. You send us a voice memo of you howling at the moon.
The most indiscreet code word.
We
howl back.
And if there's not audio of a girl going, what the fuck, in the background, you don't get the room.
She has to do it too.
Yeah,
she has to howl too.
Or else we don't know if the deal's closed,
you know?
No, that's a good point. Yeah. She's got to be howling at the moon. She has to be howling at the moon, so we know.
Exactly, and then we have, you know, audio record.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be good. Okay, cool.
That's easy enough.
But it just needs to happen because that's putting a lot on the line. Because that means that I'm like on the way home already when I send this.
Yeah, no, it's good. You're going to be in an Uber and making her howl into your voice memos.
I mean, that's hilarious. So I'm down for that.
Some dude named Mahmood in the front seat going like, what the fuck?
Yeah. You got to get the fuck out. Yeah.
He presses the safety button on his Uber. Yeah, he's
like, Noonlight comes in.
I mean, that was my big issue I wanted to settle, and I'm glad that it's settled, and I'm glad you guys are on my side for this.
Yeah, no, we'll work it out, and we're rooting for you.
Should we talk about the school shooting?
The thing about that is, though, I did text Alex, and I was like, dude, your school shooting, because you know his school shooting bit?
Yeah, I do.
Play the clip. Okay.
Oh, so good.
That's a good bit.
Yeah.
Catch him at the tiny cupboard on Saturday and Sunday.
This is not coming out for a year, so
this is never coming out.
We have a podcast from the last time we went to New York that we filmed 4 months after we got back from New York. That's
for all
still
we know,
out.
The video stopped, so
we're just getting reps in for when we do a real podcast.
I'll check.
Thank God he's gone. Am I right? Stop Asian hate, everyone. See, that's why we get guests on this podcast, is to make them check in that we'll make sure.
Yeah, I'm the IT guy.
Dude,
yeah.
Our
by
fucking
default.
Producer's asleep, dude. So.
So John texts me out of nowhere. All the text said was, your school shooting joke is going to kill in New York. And I was like, what? And yeah. I looked up New York shooting, and it was just a bunch of things about people shooting up the subway. And I was like, oh, that must be what he's talking about.
To be fair, I thought the Buffalo one was the Texas one.
Oh.
The text one that just happened, I thought that was the because
you texted
one.
Me like 12 minutes after these kids got killed that my joke's gonna do good.
I mean, I was joking yeah. that it's gonna do bad.
And
because that's one of your best jokes.
And before we move on, I want to say that we all condemn school shootings. We're not a fan.
Yeah, I condemn it.
Yeah,
and I think that there should be police officers in schools.
Yeah, I went to a high school that had a police station on campus. And all of our shootings were gang related. There was nothing mass about them. So that was safe. It was safer.
And Alex is recycling material because we just played his clip. And that's exactly what he says in his clip.
No, that's
not.
No, no, that's a new tag that we wrote 10 minutes before we started.
That's
this.
A good tag. That's a good tag.
Yeah, thank you. But yeah, so he sent me that. And the reason why my joke's not going to work is because it's about how I went to a primarily Hispanic high school. And they don't shoot up schools.
Yeah, but the guy in Texas was Hispanic.
Yeah. We probably shouldn't be joking about this.
I mean, obviously, terrible and bad, and we need gun reform. And, I mean, all these people that are worried about abortion, I mean, they should be happy that the forced kids are getting killed in the school, right?
Dude, I always wonder about these school shooters... is like
the coldest take of all time.
They're so deranged and depressed. Like why is their first reaction not to kill themselves?
Dude,
I wonder.
My mom goes, you know why the guy in Texas did the shooting?
Because he's trans.
No. Is he? Is he?
There was like something. There was like a picture of him in like a skirt. So all the right wing people were like, you see, these trans people need to be stopped.
She goes,
they're taking our gold medals and our kids.
She goes, you know why he did the shooting?
Why?
He was depressed.
But honestly, that's big of like a Gen X person to admit like mental health problems.
A cop, no less.
Yeah. She's
like, that's why I don't keep a gun in the house, John.
Yeah. So that's why she didn't bring her gun home. Play the clip. So my mom... So
just a clip of your mom beating up a homeless guy.
Oh, yeah. God.
Oh, wrong clip.
It's funny because like my mom will tell me things and then I'll look on her Instagram and it'll be like insane, like right wing, like talking points. I'll be like, Mom.
She'll say like, he must have been depressed. Like, I'm sure he was getting bullied. And then her Instagram is like, we got to seal up these borders because the illegals are shooting up. This is a bad home.
Exactly.
That's always the first thing I'm looking for when I look up a school shooting thing is like what the race is, because then I'll know what to say for the next couple weeks, you know? My mom has a gun. She has a gun, but she keeps all the pieces in different rooms, so it's like she might as well not even have a gun.
She's going to solve a jigsaw to defend herself. What's her address? What's her address? What time is she home normally?
That's her actual address.
Yeah.
This is how confident I am that no one's going to watch this podcast.
Okay. Oh, yeah? Double down. What's your social security number? Got it. Clip it.
Hey, we just flew in from L.A. and boy, are my arms tired. That's the biggest laugh I'm going to get all week.
Yeah.
Hey, play Tian's 20 minutes he's doing tonight at the bar.
Oh, man.
Wait, so you do it? What is the show? It's like a...
It's like six people, and then the show is called Talk Your Shit. I don't know. There's no premise. There's no gimmick. It's just you do 20 minutes at a bar.
If you want to split it up 10 and 10, I'm down.
Wait, all six people
if
do...
you want to come.
All six people do 20 minutes?
Yeah, yeah. I think...
I mean, that's a two-hour bar show.
They said up to 20 minutes, so I think the situation is that the show is so shitty, it's almost like a survival contest.
Okay. It's it's like that show Alone, where you have to just, like, survive in the woods as long as possible, and everybody checks out on their own.
Naked and Afraid, but a comedy show, yes.
It's like that show Survivor.
No.
No, not at all.
Oh.
If you're watching this, make sure to spoil the winner of Survivor to John.
Oh yeah, because I'm not gonna be able to fucking watch the Survivor finale tonight.
Yeah, that's John's biggest concern in this whole trip is that someone's gonna tell him who won the 58th season of Survivor.
You also have the internet.
That's what I do. Well, I have the show tonight. I have the show.
You want to see it at the island?
No, I have the show tonight, so I can't watch it. Oh, tonight. Okay. I have to watch it tomorrow morning during work.
How are you going
to
watch
that out?
I love that.
The 3-hour finale during work. Cut that out.
While he's working hard.
I love that you watch Survivor.
I love it.
I've never met, like, I people who watch these shows, I'm like fascinated by people who watch Big Brother.
I don't watch Big Brother.
Survivor is a good show. I used to watch it, but
thank you,
there's
Alex.
Literally... like hundreds of seasons at this point.
Yeah.
When you go to Survivor Australia and all the fake ones and all this other shit, it's like, stop.
Yeah, but this one's live. This one's the OG. It's live. It's going on right now.
Do you have someone you're rooting for?
Not really. The person I was rooting for got voted out already.
This is good content.
Yeah, it is.
Also, because this is going to come out in when there's been seven more Survivor seasons. Shout out to Luke Moniz. Play his clip where he talks about airports.
Every time I board a plane now, they make an announcement like, all right, there are too many bags. We didn't know everyone was going to bring a bag.
Yeah, he was on the first lab work I did. It was fun.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I talked to him very briefly because it's like tall guy connection.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
So we were both on Sam Bilski's show, right, Tian?
Uh-huh.
And this is when I met Luke. And like, you know, Alex and I are tall boys, but Luke is very tall.
Yeah, he's like 6'7".
Yeah, so Sam brings up Alex and he goes, he's really tall. Give it for Alex Holliday. Yeah. And Luke Moniz was right after Alex. So it was just insane to bring up Alex as his credit being tall when the next person is so much taller than Alex.
Yeah, I get mad at the next sub guys because they always bring me up as the most fashionable comic you'll ever see.
And that's fucked up because I'm pretty fashionable.
That's true. You got the Comedy Store sweatshirt.
You're wearing a Dodgers World Series shirt.
Hey, I got the shirt, don't I?
Next to a guy in a pea coat, and you're saying you're more fashionable?
Yeah, because he's stupid and didn't know that it's fucking hot in New York during this time.
Somebody told me it was gonna rain, first of all.
It is. It's gonna rain and be 80. That's what I said.
Oh, fuck. Oh, hilarious.
I'm sorry that I'm trying to prepare you guys for all the No,
I appreciate it. I appreciate how much I'm sweating right now, but
we're in the apartment. You can take it off.
Yeah. No, I need a stunt.
So that was just hilarious when he did that.
No, I would be kind of pissed off if that happened to me.
And I tell Luke Moniz that story every time I see him.
Really? You talk about me that much?
I tell him that story every time.
Thank you. Hell yeah.
Well, anyway, this has been the Joe Rogan Experience. Thanks for watching, guys.
Hey, We're going to get taken off YouTube now.
Yeah, come on. This has been the Joe Rogan Experience. All right. Oh,
what is that?
That
sounds familiar.
Oh,
that's Josh Edelman's thing.
Oh, he's in New York right now.
Okay, we're done. Paying LeBron, I'm paying Dwayne Wade. 3 dice, CeeLo, 3 card, Marley, Labor Day parade.